let us acknowledge our sins. And so prepare ourselves today to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, we come together as a nation into the needs of God's people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, we come in word and sacrament and send us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Thank you. And and he picked up the fragments left over, 12 wicker baskets full. Those who ate were about 5,000 men, not counting women and children. The Gospel of the Lord.
Our first reading today is about food, and it also comes from the book of the prophet Isaiah. And it's a funny thing about the book of Isaiah, you may have heard us talk about this in other places, but scripture scholars believe there are really prophecies from three different prophets on the scroll of the book of Isaiah. That first Isaiah was very interested in preserving the idea that God will keep his promise to Jerusalem and to King David. But the second prophet Isaiah lived when the people were in exile in Babylon. And his idea was that God would also keep the promise that he made, that they would be able to come home. And then there's a third Isaiah, who was called to be a prophet after they did actually come home. And so, when we look at the various texts that we read from the prophet Isaiah, we try to figure out where Isaiah is in this history. And we believe this text comes from the second prophet Isaiah, when the Jewish people were in exile in Babylon. And the message of hope that he had to share was that God was going to take care of us, that God was going to gather us together. The food images are about a great banquet that God will prepare for his people when he keeps the promises. It's kind of a messianic banquet that he calls it. So that passage puts us in mind of this. This promise that God is going to love us, he's going to feed us, he's going to take care of us. Especially when we turn to the gospel and we hear once again one of these passages in which Jesus is feeding thousands of people with just a few loaves and a few fish. These stories, the New Testament tells us this story about six times in the four gospels. Tells us this story because it's a story of hope. It's a story in which we see that Jesus is keeping the promise that the prophets made to the Jewish people in the past. Second prophet Isaiah knew that God was going to rescue them, knew he was going to bring them home. And he did. All of a sudden, the Jewish people got up one day in Babylon, and they discovered that the kingdom of the Babylonians had collapsed. The kingdom of the Persians had taken over. And the Persian king decided to send everybody home. So their life completely changed in one moment. So this was a great moment. God keeps his promises. That's what we believe when we hear these stories about God feeding us. God does keep his promise. And that's what every Eucharist is. God keeping his promise to us. God sends Jesus into our world. Jesus transforms our bread and wine into his very body and blood. And he comes to us to feed us, to strengthen us, to enable us to become someone who is able to feel in our bones the fulfillment of the promises that God has made to us. So today, as we celebrate this Eucharist together, we ask the Lord to pour out his Holy Spirit on us, to help us understand how much love God has for each one of us, and how in this Eucharist, and how in every Eucharist, He keeps His promise. He keeps sustaining us. He keeps giving us what we need so that we can truly believe in Him and let His power work in us. So with that in mind, let us pray for one another today that God will continue to bless us and continue to feed us and help us truly become people, His people of God, the people that God nourishes and sustains forever. God bless you.
Confident in the power of your love and the abundance
this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated now. This is our custom during the pandemic. We will not take up a collection, but we ask you to place your gifts in the baskets in the back of the church as you leave today. Today's collection will conclude our monthly assessment. Thank you. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice to the Lord will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. And graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal offering to you. We ask this. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. For through his national history, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now born, chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as with entered willingly into this passion. He took bread, and giving thanks, broke and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up." And in a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of God.
peace of the Lord be with you always.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Company with constant protection, O Lord, those you renew with these heavenly gifts, and in your never-failing care for them, make them worthy of eternal redemption. We ask this